And basically on this, we're going to see what you saw on that, except without the meninges and without the symphonic trunk ganglia and all that, just cord. No meninges, no trunk ganglia, no ramus communicans. So this one, once you've mastered that one, should be a piece of cake. Okay, so the cake box. Okay. But on this, for example, what would we call this right here?
Column.
Column, which one?
Anterior,
posterior. Posterior white column. Okay. Here's your anterior white column. Okay. What are we going to call this?
Horn.
Horn, which one?
Posterior.
Posterior gray horn.
Gray horn.
There's your posterior gray horn. There's a gray commissure with the central canal in the center of it. What's in the central canal?
CSF.
CSF. Okay. There's your anterior median fissure, and just like they did on the other model, they ran the thing right up, butted up against the gray commissure, which they shouldn't do. It should stop about eighth of an inch, eighth of an inch short of that, but it doesn't. Okay. So there's your columns, there's your horns, your gray commissure, central canal, anterior median fissure, posterior median sulcus. Which root is this?
Anterior.
Anterior root. Okay. What's this thing?
Ganglia, posterior.
Posterior root ganglia. Okay. By the way, you should know that the posterior root is the sensory root. The anterior root is the motor root. Posterior root is your sensory root. The anterior root is your motor root. And then they unite right here. So what's this thing?
Nerve.
Spinal nerve. That's your spinal nerve.
The posterior root is
the sensory root.
So two and three are basically studying the same information.
Yeah, except two's got a little bit more. It's got your